Okay, so I want to remind you of something that we learned from looking at x over x squared plus 1 and so forth. And that is, if we have three numbers, a less than b less than c, and we look at these three rational functions, linear over quadratics, and if we just look at the graphs of those, then without respect to where the y-axis belongs, this function will look something like this. So the y-axis will be in here somewhere. I don't know where the y-axis is in relation to a, b, and c. But if you just work out a sign chart, you find out that the function's negative to the far left, positive, negative, then positive. The horizontal asymptote is the x-axis. And so the graph's got to look something like that. If the intercept is between the asymptotes, then the graph's got to look like this. And if the intercept is to the right of the asymptotes, then the graph's got to look like this. Now, we could put plus or minus signs on here. If we put minus signs, then that would flip all these graphs over. And I won't do that here and now. But I want to apply this knowledge that we have to start looking at functions that are quadratic over quadratic. So if we start out with, say, f of x is equal to x squared minus 1 over x squared minus 4. This factors as x minus 1 times x plus 1 over x minus 2 times x plus 2. And so we have intercepts, x-intercepts at plus or minus 1, and we have vertical asymptotes at plus or minus 2. So we have an x-intercept at x equal plus or minus 1. We have vertical asymptotes at x equal plus or minus 2. The y-intercept will be equal to 1/4. And the horizontal asymptote will be the line y equals 1. The horizontal asymptote is just the ratio of the coefficients of the highest degree terms. Now let's draw out a sign chart for this function. So we have minus 2, 1, 1, and 2. The function's 0 here, it's 0 here. It's going to be undefined here, undefined here. And it's going to be very positive to the far left. It's going to be negative over here, positive in between, negative here, positive here. And so if we draw the y-axis, draw the x-axis, function 0 here, the function 0 here. It's undefined here, undefined here. These are the points negative 2, negative 1, 1, 2. The function's value at 0 is 1/4. And what happens? The function's positive. Negative, positive, negative, and then positive. And if we did long division on this, we would find out that it's x squared minus 4 goes into x squared minus 1. X squared goes into x squared one time. So when we divide through, we get, multiply through, we get x squared minus 4. So we get 1 plus 3 over x squared minus 4. And so it doesn't fall into the family that we've seen so far. It actually comes from 1 over a quadratic. So let's see what happens when we mix things up. So let's look at a function f of x is equal to x plus 2 times x minus 1 over x plus 1 times x minus 2. If we multiply both those out, then we would get x squared plus x minus 2. And downstairs, we get x squared minus x minus 2. So if we do the long division, we find out that x squared minus x minus 2 goes into x squared plus x minus 2. Well, it'll go in one time. We have x squared minus x minus 2. When we subtract, we get 2x plus 4. And so this is plus 2 times x plus 2 over x plus 1 times x minus 2. And in terms of the behavior, it's just shifted up from one of our examples over there. Now what? Let's see.
Why is it 2x plus 4?
2x.
Should it be 0 there?
2x, you're right, 2x. So 2x here, thank you. So I did the classic mistake and just wasn't watching what I was subtracting. I need to subtract there, I get 0. So let's go back here. So we've got the root is between, the place where it's 0 is between the asymptotes. And so that means that it's going to be one of the forms that we had before. So it's going to be the shape. It's going to be like this, but it's going to be shifted up one unit. Now let's finish this off with a sign chart. And so if we finish that off with a sign chart, we have to take into consideration minus 2, 1, minus 1, 1, and 2. The function is 0 at 2. The function is 0 at 1. It's undefined here. It's undefined here. Every factor is a linear factor of positive slope, so it's going to be alternating signs starting with a positive. Our y-axis belongs between these two points. We have an x-axis here. And what do we have? We have 0 here. We have an asymptote here. We have an asymptote here. We have a 0 here. We have a horizontal asymptote, which I didn't list. The horizontal asymptote is the line y equals 1. And the y-intercept is 1. So yes, the graph does cross the horizontal asymptote. That can happen. And the function is positive, negative, positive, negative, and positive. And so the rough shape was as I said it would be, and it's just shifted up by one unit. Now, I don't want to do every possible example of this here and now, but observe that you can just switch up what factors go in the numerator, and it's an extraordinarily good exercise to find out what happens with the other two processes, and what you'll find out that those two processes will be translations up of our original three cubic functions.